Hello everybody and welcome back to Uzi Mumbai, the hub of everything Mumbai City FC, where today we're going to be looking at Tandauma Singh and all the news that's been breaking out about him. Now, amidst all the silence from the club, there has been some new development on our hands. You know, we've learned that Tandauma Singh may be on his way to Trau FC, the I-League club, on a loan deal. In this video, we'll be exploring why that could have happened and we want to see if there's any fit replacement for him. Now, before anything else, we want to just say, we called it. We called it way back in July.
Which is pretty, you know, pertinent to Tandauma. His tweet, Marcus's tweet says, "Feeling bad for one player who recently joined them. Should he have a new offer, he will be allowed to leave. He seemed to have landed at Mumbai before Sergio was confirmed as coach. Another player who didn't play much last season is facing the same predicament." Now, we had a little chat about this a couple of days ago as this. You know, what we feel, it's either going to be one of Tandauma Singh or Mehtaab Singh.
When Slogan and I made that video on the thread by Marcus Sir, and he said that it is... if there's any player that's going to leave, it has to be either Tandauma Singh or Mehtaab Singh. I'd say we were right.
It's right only. You're picking like two players from a total of like 22. It's right.
Yeah. So, you know, not to, you know, pat my own back or whatever, but we are the upper echelon of football content in India now.
We're like that octopus, man. We can just predict anything. I'll make one prediction. We're gonna win the league, and it's gonna happen also.
Yeah, they're just Adam Ponder now or whatever. But now, anyways, so now as of everyone knows that, you know, the most of the Indian signings are made by the director of football, and the foreign signings is usually made by the head coach.
Yeah, but in Tandauma's case, I think what happened was that he was signed by us before the manager was confirmed. Mm-hmm. And then when Lubera came around, he realized that he wasn't going to get as much time as he wants because Mandar's coming in. Even though last season, you know, he was at Chennai and there was Jerry Lal Ranswala, who like just broke out last season. I mean, he broke out earlier, but, you know, he got a lot of time last season and he pretty much displaced Tandauma. Mm-hmm. And now Tandauma's 25 and he would want to get minutes, you know, try to kind of build his image as a consistent left back in the circuit.
Yeah.
So I think after Lubera came in, he probably explained his situation. He, coach, you know, I need to get some minutes. Either you play me or else you send me out. So, you know, negotiation. And then I think this situation came that, okay, you can go out for loan. And I think this tells us two main things, right?
Yeah.
One is that Tandauma could be on a multi-year deal because this talks about going to Trau FC on loan for 1 year.
Yeah.
And it's weird that the club would just send out a player throughout the tenure of his contract on loan.
Yeah.
And I really don't think it would be a 1 year contract to begin with, probably like 2 years, 3 years. Yeah. The second is that I think Lubera has some amount of faith in him because he's essentially said that, okay, go out, get some minutes, play a bit, show me that you can do it. I'm willing to take a risk here with my left back spot without you around so that you can give good contention next year.
I think that's a very good point, you know. So, we know with Mandar, he is going to be a, you know, first name on the team sheet. He was, you know, captain for Goa under Lubera, all the experience, the very personalized role we've talked about often on this channel about, you know, how specialized he is, Mandar. So, I think the fact that, you know, he's going out on loan shows a lot of faith in him regarding... he's risking his left back position and probably depth on the left back left hand side to allow Tandauma to go out on, you know, on loan. I don't think he's going to get a lot of minutes in Mumbai, so I think it's a good move for him. Now, if we have to look at who's going to replace him or who's going to be the squad depth on the left hand side for, you know, left back, you know, Valpuya can play on the left back, he's played there, but he's too right footed, right? And he may not be that comfortable in attack, which is something that the Goa or, I mean, Lubera's left back would love to do. most of the ISL teams have also signed left back from other teams on long term deals as well. So there's no chance of getting any one of them coming in here unless you pay a transfer fee. So then the question is, who do we bring in as a left back, or who do we think we have as a left back?
Yeah, because again, it's like we don't need just a left back. We need an attacking left back, you know.
Yeah.
And that's really, really tough to find in India. And I think the club would want someone of ISL quality. And,
exactly.
You know, they're not going to compromise much that, okay, we might sign a youngster here and then give him a few runs out. I think this season, they're going to say, no, we go for the title, get the best there is.
Yeah.
So I think what's really going to happen here is Lovera's going to do what he did with Mandar.
Mm-hmm.
And by that, I mean that he's going to take a winger from the team and he's going to convert him into a fullback. Now, we have quite a few wingers in our team, so the question would be who?
Yeah. Right?
And I think it's going to be Bipin in this case.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can remember, last season we saw Bipin play as a fullback in a game.
Yeah.
It was makeshift. I think he came on or something, or I don't know. There was some tactical change in the middle of the game and he went to fullback and he was really good there, worked so much running up and down the pitch. And he's also, you know, he wins more defensive duels than the average winger, and this is statistically proven. I'm not saying it out of intuition.
Yeah,
right? I feel that he still has to learn a bit of conventional defending.
Mm-hmm.
Proper holding your space and, you know, those basic principles of defending. But
yeah.
I think if he trains, you know, if he gets to know the ropes, he can really do well, because attacking wise he knows how to stretch space. You know, we see him going wide again and again, so he knows how to attack that space, open up space for someone else, right? And that's exactly what Lovera wants as well, someone who can get forward.
Yeah.
Someone who can pull that opposition fullback wide. So I think that, you know, if Bipin can be retrained, he could be a backup left back. Yes, there will be an empty spot on the right wing or the left wing, but it's easier to get a new winger in rather than looking for a new fullback, right?
Yeah, I think it's a very interesting take. And I think a lot of people may have issues with it that, ooh, Bipin Singh can't be a left back. That's exactly what people thought about Mandar. I know for a fact that every other prediction video before he was turned into a left back had Mandar playing on the left wing. So I genuinely think this is a very, it's a very possible future.
Yeah.
And it's yet another trademark Uzi Mumbai bold claim. Pum, 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 pum.
That's going to be true.
It's going to be true, and then you're going to cry, and then you're going to go, ooh, I should have listened to him. That's not gonna happen anyways. But you know, it's a bit of a crazy situation that we have here with Tondamba, and I hope that this move works out for the best for him, for the club, both the parties involved. And I hope that he comes back a better player and he's ready to, you know, start fighting for the left back position on a regular basis.
Yeah, definitely. We get that depth, he gets his time, he gets his experience. It's good for both.
Exactly. So I think that's it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It is a very small topic to make a video about, we realize, and we'll get another video soon, hopefully, so that this doesn't feel like a bummer. But it's an important topic to talk about, so we had to make a video on it. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to like, share and subscribe, and comment down below what do you think about this situation. And I think we'll see you soon.
Bye bye.